Hello and welcome back to another Future Doc House production. I know we're in the midst of the coronavirus, COVID-19, and everyone's been asking me about this new, well not new, this old drug, old medicine, called chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine. Chloroquine, it's in a class of aminoquinoline, okay? And this class of drugs, the indicated use is for malaria parasites, and it fights against these malaria species: Plasmodium vivax, P. ovale, P. malariae, also known as Plasmodium ovale and Plasmodium malariae. And it also has anti-inflammatory properties, so it can be used against rheumatoid arthritis and lupus erythematosus. Okay, it mildly suppresses the immune system. So this drug, chloroquine, mildly suppresses the immune system. Hydroxychloroquine, on the other hand, it does, its mechanism of action is obviously the anti-malarial issues and antiviral issues, but it also increases lysosomal pH in APCs, in antigen-presenting cells. In doing so, it reduces the activation of the inflammatory response. Thus, it's a much better candidate for rheumatoid arthritis and lupus. Side effects: vision. You can lose your eyesight, vision. It causes retinopathy. You can lose your eyesight. It can also damage your hearing, tinnitus, and give you some mental issues. Causes muscle weakness, low blood cell levels, and of course the overdose. Overdose, do not take too much of this because you can overdose. And the overdose happens over 1 milligram or 1 gram. This medicine can be used as an anti-parasitic in aquarium fish tanks. But usually those packets come in 10 gram tablets. 10 gram is 10 times the dose that a human can have. It's toxic, it's lethal, and you can die from this. As an anti-malarial, let's look at this picture here. As an anti-malarial, you have a parasite, the malaria parasite in blue, invading a red blood cell in red. And if the red blood cell has a nucleus, think a parasite, a malarial parasite, because red blood cells do not have a nucleus. It's a nucleus. It has no nucleus. And so if you see this, this is a telltale sign that it's infected by a malaria parasite. Now these brown spots are hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is what carries oxygen in a red blood cell. This parasite eats the hemoglobin as food. Problem with hemoglobin is it's made up of two parts: heme, which is iron, a toxic form of iron, and globin. Globin is a protein, and it's digested and turned into energy or whatever it needs to create proteins. Now, here's what happens. The heme, which is broken up from hemoglobin, is black. And this is really, really toxic. This is iron toxic, okay? And the parasite converts this into a biocrystallized form, which is pink. Here's where chloroquine comes in. Chloroquine enters the cell, and it caps off all the hemoglobin, making the hemoglobin very, very toxic, as well as it prevents this conversion of the toxic heme into biocrystallized form heme, which is safe. And so this poor parasite is now becoming iron toxic, as well as this cell is becoming membrane damaged because this new, say, chloroquine hemoglobin is very toxic to the red blood cell. The red blood cell dies, encasing the parasite that's kind of poisoned with the iron, and it gets autodigested and everything dies within the cell. So that's what happens to the malaria parasite in the red blood cell with chloroquine. Now, this is a host cell and this is a virus. As an antiviral agent, you've got the coronavirus. I use the coronavirus just since we're talking about it. It's a coronavirus pandemic. And this enters in. It enters in through endocytosis. So it takes a bit of the cell membrane enters into the cell and has that cell membrane in it now. Now, inside the endosome, this is an endosome with the virus inside it, it's usually low pH, very, very low pH, very acidic, okay? That's why it's in red. Now, you see a bit of blue in there. Here's why, because chloroquine comes in and prevents this endosome from releasing the virus, content into the host cell and causing the host cell to replicate the DNA, replicate the virus. And so it kind of gets trapped in here and kind of stuck in here. So it's kind of like the endosome is the Uber that never unlocked the doors, and the passenger, the virus, is stuck inside and cannot be released. Well, it cannot be released, it cannot replicate, so it cannot infect the body. So that's how chloroquine works inside the host cell, preventing infection. So it's basically an effective inhibitor of SARS-CoV. As far as COVID-19, we still are doing research and trying to figure that out. Okay, so that's chloroquine and hydroxychloroquine for you. If you like this video and you want more of these videos, please click subscribe. Thank you, and have a nice day.
She is a good student, but instead of just reading textbooks late into the night, Jennifer uses technology to help her study. She also watches lectures on YouTube and practices her knowledge with QUPI, a medical quiz app and online platform. Jennifer likes QUPI because it has 10,000 practice questions covering her entire medical course. This means she can practice her medical knowledge from anywhere and in a way that actually prepares her for the exams. Begin your 7-day free trial with QUPI today.